I discovered the real secret of millionaires, the true secret to being happy, fulfilled, and successful. And do you want to know how to be rich? Just watch this video until the end. What I found in my research is that there are a series of qualities that millionaires have. If you have these qualities, or if you start developing them from now on, you can rest assured that your success is practically guaranteed. The first thing you need to do is develop a clear sense of direction. There's a very important phrase that says, if you don't know where you're going, any road will take you there. So think about it. You can't hit a target you can't see. You have to know what you want in all areas of your life. A few years ago, the richest man in the world was asked about the secret of success. The man interviewing him wanted to know the secret to being rich. He said that the keys to success, and consequently being rich, are only two. And it's what I did throughout my life, so write this down, because I'm going to tell you what they are. Number one, he said to decide exactly what you want and write it down. And number two is to determine the price you will have to pay to get it, and then resolve to pay that price. Now let me give you a quick exercise. I want you to take a piece of paper and write down 10 goals you would like to achieve in the next 12 months. Write the word goals and today's date at the top of the page. Write down all these goals you would like to achieve and ask yourself this big question. If you could achieve only one goal on this list, which one would have the greatest positive impact on your life? Circle that goal and then turn the page, and at the top of the page, set a deadline for the goal. Make a list of everything you could think of doing to achieve the goal, and then start working on your list. And here's the secret. Do something every day. Do something every day that moves you one step closer to your main goal. If it's to be rich, move toward it. If it's to be healthier, do something that moves you toward it, and so on. I promise you that this exercise, selecting your most important goal, making a plan, and working on it every day, will change your life in ways you can't imagine. It's the secret to becoming a millionaire. My promise to you is that in a week, a month, a year, you will look back and be absolutely amazed at the difference it makes. People who truly want to be rich, they commit to that goal. So I want you to commit. Comment like this. I commit to being rich. Just comment this. I commit to being rich. When I see this comment, I will give you a heart because I know you will achieve it soon. Now I have something important to teach you, so pay close attention. Lesson number two is trust your ideas. And that's the only difference between very rich and successful people and ordinary people. It's that they simply follow their intuition. They're not smarter, they're not different, they're not more educated, they're not more talented. They just follow this inner guide. According to research, all you need is an idea that's 10% newer to start a fortune. Most people become millionaires by offering a good or service that people use all the time. They offer it a little better, they do it a little faster, they put a little more grace or subtlety into what they're doing, they handle, wrap, and are more dedicated. You need to find an idea that is 10% different, and you'll find that it will flood your mind. Read magazines, read books, ask questions, ask why people are doing things the way they are, look for ideas. Keep your mind open and flexible. Remember that a new idea is all you need to start a fortune. What you need to do is trust your ideas. Third, what you need is to practice what top people practice, which is what we call visualization. You project several years ahead and imagine that your life is perfect in every way. Now what we've found is that this is the starting point of great wealth, and it's the starting point of great success in life. For you to have a dream, a wonderful future vision, here's an exercise we give to people. Take a sheet of paper and make what we call a dream list. Just write down everything you could think of and could wish for. I had a friend I taught this to, and he got very excited about this idea. He bought a spiral notebook and started writing and flipping through the newspaper and every little thing he saw in the newspaper. The interesting thing is that his life exploded. He activated the law of attraction and started attracting people into his life. Ideas, resources in synchronicity. This began to move him toward achieving the goals and began to move the goals toward him. The next key to becoming a millionaire is to associate with the right people. That's the key to becoming a millionaire, because Dr. David Mackler at Harvard did studies for 25 years to find out why some people were so successful in life. What he found was that 99% of your success in life will be determined by what he called your reference group. It's the people you habitually associate with, because we are like chameleons and we absorb through our skin the attitudes, opinions, behaviors, dressing style, speaking style of the people you spend most of your time with. If you start associating with winners, most of the time you'll find they have a completely different worldview. They're positive, optimistic, focused, they're learning, they're growing, they're positive about what they're doing, and you start to become like that. The law of attraction is that if you change the way you think, you'll start to attract new people into your life. And if you become aggressive about personal development and personal growth, you start to meet other people who think the same way. And the old groups of people you associated with disappear, and the new group of people appears. So, people wonder, where do I find positive people who are thinking about success all the time? First, you become one, and then you naturally attract them. It's like magic. Refuse to consider the possibility of failure. The rule is that this is not failure. You will fail once in a while, but your brain has a cybernetic mechanism, which means that every time you try something, you get feedback. You become smarter and eventually get to the point where you're too smart and stop making mistakes. You start to do more and more things right and less things wrong, but you can't get there unless you experience the failures. And let me convey to you a great rule that was discovered when interviewing millionaires. Millionaires look at every failure for something good. They say there must be something good in this that I can benefit from, and they always find it. Secondly, millionaires always look for the valuable lesson in every setback, obstacle, or temporary failure. They always find the lesson, what can I learn from this that will make me smarter next time? Your biggest problem today can be the greatest gift you've ever had, because it may contain the lesson that will make you successful if you stop thinking about what happened and who's to blame and start looking for the gift within your problem. Sometimes this can transform your life, and I love Socrates' line that says, "An unexamined life is not worth living," which means that in life you don't set aside time to reflect on your experiences. Aristotle said that wisdom is an equal measure of experience plus reflection, and the reason so few people have wisdom is that they have continuous experiences, but they never stop to sit and reflect on what's happening to them, reflect on what they're learning. How many people have seen people leave bad relationships and immediately go back to other bad relationships, leave a bad job and immediately enter another bad job? What's the natural thing people do? They get fired from a job, they walk down the street, and what do they look for? Another job exactly like the one they left. Does this seem normal, or is it something extraordinary to be understood? Very well, let's move on to the next step, which is more important than this one. The next step is to develop a different mindset. I'll tell you one thing about hard work. Our society only works 8 hours a day for survival. Anything above 8 hours is for success. If you work just 8 hours a day, it's better to win the lottery, have a rich uncle, or have someone take care of you, because 8 hours a day only gives you survival in our society. Because it's so competitive that someone is working 9, others have decided to work 10 hours. And you want to know something intriguing? Yes, they have a huge advantage over you. Someone is working 11 hours and 30 minutes. They have a much, much greater advantage over you. From 8 hours up that you invest is an investment in your future. It's an investment in your success. And if you dedicate more than 8 hours, whether studying, reading, or working, if you dedicate hours, it will be worth it. It's like planting a seed in fertile soil. When you plant a seed in the ground, the plant that grows is not just one seed. It's hundreds of seeds. There's a harvest that you plant, but first you must put the seed in the ground. The next key is to dedicate yourself to lifelong learning. Now, what takes you from misery to wealth is personal development. If you're not constantly learning, the next thing to do is to take every possible course. When you take a course, you can learn enough information in 1 or 2 days, more than you could learn in 2 or 3 years, or maybe a lifetime. A few years ago, I had a dentist just before retiring. He sold his practice for about $2 million shortly before retiring. He told me the reason. He said about 8 years before, he attended a dental conference in Hong Kong and began implementing that in his clinic. People started flying 500 to 1,000 miles away. Every dentist sent their family members and themselves to this dentist, and he was able to charge whatever he wanted with what he learned in one session at a convention in a course. Now that's a true story, and maybe it's an exception, but you can never tell where information comes from. This you must keep secret. The third way to upgrade your skills is to listen to audio programs in your car. An average person wins in life when they invest in themselves, read, learn, and improve their skills. You're telling yourself, "Wow, I'm a person with a great future, and it's up to me to maximize my potential," and your self-esteem rises, your high regard rises, your sense of personal pride rises, and you start to be more promoted in all areas of your life. Then be prepared to rise from the top to the top. One of the keys to becoming a millionaire is realizing that life is never a continuous train. It's always up and down, and the certainty is that this curve is usually upward, so that every time there's a step back, there's still more ahead than before. The next step is to develop resilience and bounce back. You will be knocked down repeatedly. Life is a continuous series of problems. They never end. Problems keep coming like ocean waves. The only interruption in this unbroken series of problems will be the occasional crisis. So life will be problem and crisis. It's like ocean waves. And you must be wondering, how do I solve this? Here's the secret. Start writing down your problems so they're easier to solve. If you have a problem, stop and think. What's my problem? What is it that worries me? And write it down. And the act of clearly defining a problem often triggers the solution to the problem. A philosophy I carry with me is a defined problem is 50% solved. So clearly define what your problems are. You've already identified the goal that can have the greatest positive impact on your life. Now, what you do is take that goal and put it at the top of a page in the form of a question. If your goal is to double your income and this can have a great impact on your life, stay up later, change your occupations, upgrade your skills, whatever it is, keep striving. Write until you have 20 answers. We call this brainstorming. The first 5 answers will be easy. The next 5 answers will be difficult. The last 10 answers will be incredibly difficult. I've given this exercise to people who became millionaires so many times that I lost count, because they often find that the 20th answer changes their entire life. And if you do this once, learn the right thing at the right time. Another thing you need to learn is that rich people try more things, which dramatically increases the likelihood that they will try the right thing at the right time. And even more importantly, they persist. They never give up once they decide they will become rich. They never stop until they achieve that goal. Now, there will be many setbacks, obstacles, and difficulties. You know that almost everyone succeeds in a different direction than they originally intended or thought. But they love their fears. Confront their fears. Do what you fear, and fear dies. Now, fear and courage tend to be habits. If you're afraid and let it dominate you and end up backing down, it becomes a habit to back down whenever you're afraid or unsure. If you're afraid and force yourself to face the fear, it becomes a habit to confront fear whenever you encounter something that frightens you. And you'll find that most fears disappear when you confront them. Dare to move forward in your life. Activate yourself a few times a week. You're not pushing hard enough if you're not drying your tears frequently. If you're not shaking when you go to sleep, with your heart pounding hard, you're not pushing hard enough. You're living too much within your potential. All really successful people live outside the edge of what they're capable of, and it's always a little scary outside the edge, because we all have feelings of uncertainty. We all have fears. That's the master key to wealth. After studying 500 of the richest people in American history, he said, "It's the quality of self-discipline. It's the ability to force yourself to do what needs to be done, even when you don't feel like doing it. The quality of self-discipline is the quality that will make you a great success. It's the ability to force yourself to do what you know you should do." And here's the wonderful discovery that persistence is self-discipline. Every time you persist, you create discipline. Finally, people will say, "I know one thing about him. I've used one thing about her." You can't stop them. Once they decide they want something, they don't stop until they get it. And when you develop that quality, there will be nothing that's impossible for you. To make this teaching ingrained in your mind, I suggest you watch this video at least 7 times, and each time you watch, I'm sure you'll learn something new that went unnoticed in the previous times you watched. And remember that if your goal is to be rich, that should be your focus, and don't get distracted, and make a commitment. When you get rich, commit to helping other people, because true wealth is when you overflow into other people's lives. And you're only watching this video because of that reason. I made this commitment when I was still poor. I said that when I got rich, I would help other people become rich too. So that was my contribution for today. If you've watched this far, comment like this: "True wealth is when you overflow into other people's lives." Just comment that: "True wealth is when you overflow into other people's lives." When I see this comment, I'll know you watched to the end. After you comment, immediately click on the video that's appearing on your screen. It contains a lot of practical knowledge that I'm sure will add a lot of value to your financial life. So click on it and go watch.